kind of the, I mean, I don't think, I mean, that's what I'm saying, I don't know what color is.
I mean, I'm just scared from last, just last.
Make plans to attend that. It's a very good time. good fellowship, the great food.
The canned goods.
Canned goods, yes. Men bring canned goods for that. That's something that's going to begin each month, beginning on next Sunday. So we'll bring canned goods to be donated for a special cause. So that's a good reminder. When we're getting ready to sit down for a buffet breakfast, remember to bring some canned goods for those who are less fortunate than we. Any other announcements? If no, I just want to take this time to share with Pastor Lucas and with you all. Thanks for wonderful Christmas Eve services. That was very special. And the 7 o'clock service was very special, with having, I think, West Carolina 8 or 9 very little, tiny kids. And that was just special. As Lucas said, bring them. They're here. They made noise. They ran around. Several parent trips back and forth. Good stuff. They're in the right place. So, again, that was just a special moment of Christmas for me personally. And just want to give a shout out to those that made that happen. Thank you for a wonderful time of worshiping with the small ones and just sharing the Christmas story in a different way. But to share the Christmas story and to tell that that's what the true meaning of Christmas story is. Again, thanks for being here today, and have a great day, and continue to have a Merry Christmas.
Yeah. anew in our hearts. Open our ears that we may hear again the angelic chorus of old. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward all, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. I do realize that I am in a different space. I didn't say good morning, church, to start off with. So good morning to all of you. Welcome to our Festival of Nine Lessons and Carols. Tia and I yesterday, after the day after Christmas, we had to go buy some cheap wrapping paper. So we went to the store, and as we left, the woman who checked us out said, "Have a good rest of your weekend." And I said to her, "Merry Christmas." And Tia, as we're walking out the door, was like, "Goodness, Christmas is over." I said, "No, it is not. Christmas is not over until Epiphany on January 6th. And so we are still find ourselves here in this season of Christmas. And as the great philosopher Buddy the Elf taught us, the best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear. And so that is what we are going to do today. There is not going to be a sermon. Sometimes the best sermon is just hearing the scripture read beautifully, said over, especially over the course of all the scriptures that we're going to hear today. And so that is what we're going to do. We're going to hear nine scriptures, and then we're going to sing nine carols, portions of different carols. You do not have to stand. Those of you who are in here, you do not have to stand to sing all of those ones. I will invite you to stand on the last one. But let us go to God at this time as we listen for the word of the Lord, both read and proclaimed through our voices today. Our first lesson comes to us from Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 through 15, and then verses 17 through 19. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." And to the man he said, "Because you have listened to the voice of your wife, and have eaten of the tree about which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you. And you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread until you return to the ground. For out of it you are taken. You are dust. Into dust you shall return."
Thank you. angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand that is on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of your enemies, and by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice.
Thank you. Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time he said to Bethany, said to them, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may go out and pay him homage." When they heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Nature.
years. That's good. But that's what it says on the screen. So that is what how I'm going to pray this prayer of thanksgiving and intercession today. There will be a list of petitions that I will say over the course of the prayer, and I invite you to say, and I will say, Lord, in your mercy, and you will respond with, hear our prayers. So let us go to God in prayer this time. Before we go to God in prayer, though, I have a few concerns to lift up with the community. We want to continue to be in prayer for family and friends of Janet Brady Bridges and her unexpected death on Christmas Day. We also want to give God praise for some good reports on all of those in our own community who have been affected by COVID-19. We also want to continue to be in prayer for all who might be traveling this day, this weekend, this time of the year, and all of those who are alone and separated from their loved ones during this season as well. Let us go to God in prayer at this time. Almighty God, we come to you today on this last Sunday of the year. A year that has been painful. A year that has made us have to work harder and think differently and do things in ways we never thought we were going to have to do. But Lord, through it all, we give thanks that you were with us. As we will celebrate during this season of Christmas how you came to be with us, we give thanks that you were with us hand in hand every step of the way through this year. Through the pains and the trials, through the joys and the tribulations, Lord, we give thanks that we had one another, that we had you. Lord, during this time, we pray for those whom we have lost. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For those who have lost jobs and those who are hurting financially, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For those who receive poor health reports, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the unknown that faces us all, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
But in the midst of all of those concerns, Lord, we also have joys, things that we are thankful for in this year. For the creativity that the Holy Spirit has given us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the connection of community and family that this church brings us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the blessings upon blessings that we have received in the midst of such trying times. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Lord, once again we give thanks for your presence among us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
Lord, as we close off this year and as we begin a new one, might we carry Jesus with us into that new year. Might we be reminded to sing of this truth, to sing of this life, to sing of this love with everything that we have. Lord, we pray all of this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is always teaching us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
time, I invite you to stand as you are able as we sing our closing hymn, Go Tell It on the Mountain. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, go now in peace. Amen.